Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to really one of the great nights of the year and a day I look forward to each and every year. And that's the 2016 Black Knight Awards, a celebration for all that our cadet athletes here at West Point have accomplished over the past year. As always, we have a fantastic evening lined up for you. My name is Rich DeMarco. I'll serve as your Master of Ceremonies for tonight's program. Not only will we hand out some very deserving awards, we will relive some of the most celebrated moments in Army athletics over the last 12 months. I see so many familiar faces in the crowd as we have each and every year. Thank you all for coming out tonight. I'd especially like to thank General Caslin, his wife Shelley, General Holland, General Trainer, Colonel Brazel, Lieutenant Colonel Marcus Wilde, his wife Adrian, Colonel Green, his wife Tara, Colonel Drago, and Command Sergeant Majors Rippelmeyer and Clark for taking time out of their busy schedules to be with us this evening. It's an honor to welcome all of you along with our Academy guests who are with us tonight. Thank you for providing such tremendous support throughout the year. I speak on behalf of everyone in this room when I say it's greatly appreciated by all of our coaches, administrators, and cadet athletes. I'd now like to invite Director of Athletics Boo Corrigan to the stage to officially open tonight's program. Ladies and gentlemen, Boo Corrigan.
Thanks, Rich. It's okay to boo me when I come up, just for the record, if you want to do that. General Caslin, Ms. Caslin, General Trainer, Dr. Brazel, General Holland, Command Sergeant Major Clark, Rippelmeyer. Thank you all very much for being here. This is a special day, a special evening for us. Last year, when I stood here, we talked about winning, and last year's senior class was the winningest class in 18 years. I'm very happy to report they're no longer the winningest class in 18 years. It's this group of firstmen. And it was part of the challenge, right, of what's your legacy going to be. So they stepped up to the challenge. And you look at the championships that we had this year. Rich, you got me on this, right? Women's basketball. Women's basketball, women's rugby. Sprint football is a world champion, not just an Olympic champion. Gymnastics shared a championship this year. Second year in a row that they got a championship. Men's tennis, who I don't know is if men's tennis is back yet or not, they were in California yesterday. And then men's golf is actually competing right now. So as you look at what it is, we're doing it there. Two regiments, Katie Holder and Andrew Bohr, regimental commanders, unbelievably excited about what that means and what, how we're represented there. Thanks for all you do. It's a big deal. Before I leave, there's three people who I'd like to recognize who I think we all owe a debt of gratitude to for their work with us. And they're leaving us, but it's a big deal. And I think it's really important that all of us recognize it. Command Sergeant Major Clark, thank you for showing us what right looks like. We appreciate all that you've done in the short period of time that you've been here. General Trainer, thank you for all you've done for me personally, but for everyone in this room. Dr. Brazel, thank you very much for being a part of everything that's happened here. So on behalf of the Athletic Department, thank you very much. That, I'll turn it back over to Rich.
And Boo, I'm going to ask you to remain on the stage. We're going to honor several individuals who earned outstanding honors this year. If you're in attendance, we ask you make your way to the stage to receive an athletic director's coin. Come up stage left if you could, and then remain on the stage until all the names have been called in that particular category. And we ask the audience to hold your applause until all those have been announced in each category. First up, we're going to honor our League Major Award winners from the 2015-2016 year. First off, Cole Casanova, ECAC Gymnastics Rookie of the Year. Philip Choi, Collegiate Sprint Football League Co-Most Valuable Player. Jesse Glenn, Nissan Emory Award winner and ECAC Gymnastics Senior Athlete of the Year. Casey McCravey, Patriot League Softball Player of the Year. Brandon McCready, Patriot League Men's Swimming and Diving Rookie of the Year. Kelsey Minato, Patriot League Women's Basketball Player of the Year and Patriot League Tournament Most Valuable Player. David Mitchell, Patriot League Men's Tennis Rookie of the Year and Patriot League Tournament MVP. Renee Poré, Patriot League Softball Rookie of the Year. We'd also like to recognize, not with us tonight, Grant Reekman and Harrison McCormick, Patriot League Men's Tennis Doubles Team of the Year. They're on their way back from the NCAA Championships. And also, Dean Sakata, Patriot League Men's Golfer of the Year. Dean and the golf team, they're in Albuquerque, getting set to compete in the NCAAs. Let's have a round of applause for all of our league major award winners.
Everyone smile right there with Maddie. Hope she can get it. All right, good job.
Congratulations again. Let's take a brief moment. Our next category has one person. That's Austin Schultz of the Army Men's Lacrosse Team Patriot League Scholar Athlete of the Year honors. Congratulations, Austin. Next, we're going to honor our All-Americans from the past year. Seth Cannon, USA Gymnastics All-American on parallel bars. Cole Casanova, USA Gymnastics All-American on all-around and still rings. Leo Genders, USA Gymnastics All-American on high bar and floor exercise. Jesse Glenn, USA Gymnastics All-American on all-around, high bar, parallel bars, and vault. Sam Kuznets, USA Gymnastics All-American on floor exercise. And Kelsey Minato, WBCA and Associated Press All-American. How about a round of applause for our All-Americans? While tonight is all about the cadet athletes, we cannot let the following accomplishments go unnoticed. Will the following coaches make their way to the stage at this time? These outstanding mentors were rewarded with Coach of the Year honors in 2015-2016. With us tonight, Michelle DiPolo, head softball coach. Carmine Giglio, assistant gymnastics coach. And Doug Van Everen, head gymnastics coach. Not with us tonight is Carl Schrade. He shared the Gymnastics Coach of the Year award with Carmine and Doug, as well as men's tennis coach Jim Poling, golf coach Brian Watts. They're both traveling and at the NCAA Championships. Our coaches of the year. Big one coming up now. It is. One more after this, actually. I fooled you there. Getting back to our cadet athletes, the following individuals qualified for the NCAAs in their respective sports. Bryce Barnes, wrestling. Nathan Brewer, rifle. Seth Cannon, gymnastics. Cole Casanova, gymnastics. Logan Everett, Wrestling. We'd like to have you please come up to the stage here when you're being named. Leo Genders, Gymnastics. Alyssa Getzel, Rifle. Jesse Glenn, Gymnastics. Nathan Goff, Gymnastics. Brian Harvey, Wrestling. Elliot Herman, Gymnastics. Andre Huffnagel, Gymnastics. Samson Imanode, Wrestling. Sam Kuznets, Gymnastics. Russell Parsons Jr., Wrestling. And Ryan Wilson, Gymnastics. And not with us tonight, one NCAA qualifier. That's Joe Pritz from the gymnastics team. How about that? Our individual NCAA qualifiers. Congratulations once again. Now one more. We would like to ask the following team captains for the following sports. All six won their respective conference titles. Three earned a berth in the NCAA tournament. We have four of those sports with us here tonight. Women's basketball, Patriot League champions, and NCAA qualifiers. Gymnastics, co-ECAC champions. Sprint football, Collegiate Sprint Football League champions. Women's rugby, National Intercollegiate Rugby Association Sevens champions. Also, Patriot League champions not with us tonight. Golf and men's tennis, as we mentioned, both on the road, traveling and competing in the NCAAs. A job well done by all of our players and coaches. Put your hands together for our conference and national champions. And thank you, Boo. So let's get the video portion of tonight's program rolling. Can't think of a better way to kick things off. Some of our Play of the Year nominees, as well as our top bloopers of 2015. 2016. Men's soccer, Chris Britt's leaping save at Holy Cross. Hockey, Connor Anderle's one-handed goal against AIC. Sprint football, Matthew Tamburi's block extra point against Navy. Softball, Casey McCravey scoring an acrobatic run in the Patriot League tournament against Lehigh. Men's lacrosse, Nate Jones's goal against Navy. Men's basketball, Tanner Plum's one-handed alley-oop dunk versus NJIT. Wrestling, Logan Everett's pin against Hofstra.
You not smell my laugh?
Go, go, go.
Okay. On three or after three or?
I got
one, two, three.
Then you start, right?
Yeah. Okay. That's how it works.
Okay.
I don't know, man. I'm trying to put this bad boy on here.
New Year's revolution. I'm going back to sleep.
This is fancy. I like this. Mike check.
Inside center, Army West Point Women's Rugby. I said Bugby, that's it.
I'm sorry, I suck at this.
It's the Newton's cradle.
Yeah, it's whatever.
Jingle bell. Oh gosh. I'm starting over.
I mean, Cam Newton has swag, so there's nothing wrong with being compared to Cam Newton. Yeah, what's that from?
Helping deal with his stick. Wow, you need? Do you have a heat gun still?
I think that's the shit. What did you say?
Do you like the wave with my tongue? It's like.
Green Bay Packers.
That's what kind of runs through our minds when we do this. Okay, can I start over?
I'm not used to talking and using my brain.
Whoever said that, yeah, I just go on tangents. Sorry.
Jingle around the clock. That's not it. But whatever.
Carolyn Bachrath, middle blocker, West Point Army Volleyball.
Darn it! Come on! Darn it!
And was that the question? Sorry. I'm on a roll right now. I'm on a roll.
In the frosty air!
So for the past 3 years, we haven't... I'll restart again.
Us doing well against Penn. Shoot. All
right. Scooby Gahagan. Parker Hagan, goaltender. What's the other part?
Oh my god, this is on there. That's amazing.
Well, that's not the microphone. You don't have to hold it up like that. Oh, I know. He is recording. We're going to make the bloopers this year.
Proof the cameras are always rolling. We've been doing these bloopers enough years. Not going to buy it when people are surprised something would end up on that blooper reel. But a job well done. Again, 2015-2016. A quick reminder, following tonight's show, we're going to ask everyone to stick around for a montage. Some of the best photos from the 2016 Black Knight Awards we'll have up here on the screen. So a new element for this year's awards. Make sure you stick around just after we finish. Well, right now, let me welcome head women's basketball coach Dave McGarity to the stage to present our first award, which is given annually in memory of a young woman who inspired every single person around her, and that's late Army women's basketball coach Maggie Dixon. Before her sudden passing in 2006, Maggie was known for her fearlessness, competitiveness, and true passion for sport. Tonight, we honor our cadet athletes who showcase that very spirit each and every day. Before we get to the winner, here are tonight's finalists. Sydney Hawkins, women's track and field. Jean Parker, women's basketball. And Carolyn Pittman, women's tennis. And the winner of the 2016 Maggie Dixon Inspiration Award is Sydney Hawkins. While being unable to train effectively for the first 3 weeks of the outdoor season, Sydney overcame that obstacle in preparation for the star meet. She anchored the 4x100 relay team to victory in a new meet record and won the 400-meter run by clocking a personal best time. She's consistently been a team leader and embodies the values of what the Maggie Dixon Award represents, a willingness to always challenge herself and a love of competition. Ladies and gentlemen, Sydney Hawkins. At this time, I would like to invite Army's own Chris Perry to the stage, as well as Amanda Uchaz-Clark, to present the Jean Uchaz Memorial Award. The Army Athletics family lost a tireless worker, an invaluable member of our staff, and more importantly, a wonderful friend 6 years ago. Those of you who knew Jean Uchaz knew his smile, his jokes, and perhaps most importantly, his undying love for the Boston Red Sox and distaste for the Navy midshipmen. Gene was a behind-the-scenes guy, never looking for public praise or gratitude, but always was there to lend a hand no matter what anyone needed. Just over 6 years ago, Gene lost a 10-month battle with lymphoma and the Army Athletics family lost a dear friend. At that time, it was decided an award would be given in his memory at this event. Gene embodied the true meaning of being a team player, and all of tonight's nominees for the Gene Uchaz Memorial Award have that same spirit. The nominees are Alexandra Bell, volleyball, Alex Clark, men's soccer, and Haley O'Connor, women's tennis. And the winner of the Gene Uchaz Memorial Award is Alexandra Bell. Alexandra serves as the tutoring chair of the Cultural Affairs Seminar and organizes study sessions for the majority of the core courses that freshmen take each year. Alexandra has taken to the role of cadet academic liaison, working alongside the team's CEP advisor to coordinate a study hall schedule for any Army teammates struggling in classes. Ladies and gentlemen, the Gene Uchaz Memorial Award winner, Alexandra Bell. Congratulations, Alexandra. Moving on, our next award focuses on giving back. Right now, I'd like to invite Associate Athletic Director Gene McIntyre to the stage to help present the Community Service Award. The list of community service projects our cadet athletes have participated in is certainly not lacking for length. While several of our cadet athletes have spent many generous hours out in the community and helping to better our society at home and abroad, one stands above the rest. Our winner is the leader of the West Point Community Service Committee and is consistently involved in service projects, large and small. She recently led a group of cadets at a soup kitchen in New York City. She will spearhead the swimming and diving team's efforts in running with the Special Olympics. She also volunteers with the West Point youth involved in the swim program at Crandall Pool. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's Community Service Award winner goes to women's swimming and diving firstie, Kate Kinley. Congratulations, Kate. Before we move on to the rest of the show, it's important to point out that while we'll be seeing video highlights of our award finalists tonight, a complete listing of all nominees for each of our remaining categories can be found in tonight's program. Now let's keep the show moving along with the awards. Would Executive Athletic Director Bob Beretta join me on the stage to help present the Men's Rookie of the Year Award. The plebe year at West Point is often the most challenging of the 4 years, so it's even more impressive that these cadets were able to make an immediate impact on their respective teams in their first season. Please direct your attention to the video screen for a look at the Men's Rookie of the Year finalists. Nathan Brewer, rifle. Brewer captured the small bore gold medal at the 2016 National Junior Olympic Championships and was one of only three competitors to place in the top five in all three disciplines at the event, finishing second in prone rifle after having the highest score in the final round, which was 2 points shy of the open finals world record. Brewer placed seventh in the small bore at the NCAA Championships after being invited as an individual competitor and was the only individual invite to make the final round of eight and one of only three freshmen to do so. Kenneth Brinson, football, track and field. Brinson appeared in every game on the gridiron for the Black Knights and made six starts at outside linebacker, notching a career-high four tackles against Navy and returning a block punt for a touchdown against Tulane. In track and field, Brinson earned second place at the Patriot League Indoor Championships in the weight throw and posted season-best throws for the Black Knights in the Outdoor Star Match, where he won the hammer throw and placed second in the discus. Cole Casanova, gymnastics. Casanova was an NCAA qualifier in the all-around and was listed second among NCAA qualifiers and 15th nationally. Casanova ranked in the top 50 on floor exercise, still rings, and vault, was ECAC Rookie of the Year, and gained medalist honors in all-around and on-floor exercise in the win over Air Force. And the Black Knight Award goes to Nathan Brewer. This is Nathan's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Walla Walla, Washington, he is a member of Company E3. Our female rookies were equally as impressive throughout the year. I'll now ask that last year's Women's Rookie of the Year, Carolyn Bockrath, come to the stage as we present to this year's winner. Here are the three finalists for Women's Rookie of the Year. Kirby Inc., tennis. Inc. led Army in spring singles victories and was third on the team in doubles wins, capturing 15 straight doubles matches between February 12th and April 2nd, including a 6-2 win against Navy with senior Carolyn Pittman. Inc. won 10 straight singles matches during that same time frame and topped Navy 6-4, 6-2 in the fourth single spot. Cassie Mundakis, cross country, track and field. Mundakis won the Patriot League Indoor Championship in the 800-meter run and broke the 20-year-old program indoor record in the 800-meter run at the Penn State National Invitational. Mundakis was part of the 4x800-meter relay at the Patriot League Indoor Championships that cracked the 9-minute mark for the first time in Academy history, as well as the 4x400-meter indoor relay that set a meet record against Navy. Mundakis also scored in all five of Army's cross-country races. Renee Poré, softball. Poré was named the Patriot League Rookie of the Year, breaking the Army and Patriot League single-season records for saves. Poré currently is the nation's saves leader. And the Black Knight Award goes to Renee Poré. This is Renee's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Plainville, Massachusetts, Renee is a member of Company I-1. Congratulations, Renee. Would Associate Athletic Director Gaylord Green please make his way to the stage to present as we check out the best that our yearlings had to offer in 2015-2016. First up, Men's Yearling of the Year. Connor Anderle, hockey. Anderle led Army with 33 points, which were the most by an Army player since 2010. With seven of his team leading 13 goals on the power play, Anderle had six multi-point games, including a pair of three-point outings, with points in 25 of 38 games played. Lee Bears, track and field. Bears won seven straight pole vault competitions between February 6th and April 9th, defeating Navy both indoor and outdoor during that stretch, as well as capturing the Patriot League Indoor Championship. Bears set the pole vault record for the outdoor star match and posted a meet record in the event at the University of Virginia. Jake Lakina, rugby. Lakina finished the year with 8 tries for 40 points and scored a program record 4 tries in a 27-22 win over Navy on March 26th. And the Black Knight Award goes to Jake Lakina. This is Jake's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Thousand Oaks, California, he's a member of Company I-2. Before we move on, I'd like to welcome last year's Women's Yearling of the Year, Allison Haley, to the stage to present as we take a look at our three finalists for Women's Yearling of the Year. Carolyn Bachrath, volleyball. Bachrath earned second team All-Patriot League recognition and was voted to the Patriot League All-Tournament team after leading the conference in hitting percentage and ranking as high as fourth in the nation during the season. Tops in the Army record book in single season hitting percentage, Bachrath also led the Black Knights in kills and kills per set. Bria Brown, track and field. Brown was the Patriot League Indoor Championships winner in the shot put and broke her own school record in the shot put at the Bucknell Outdoor Classic. Brown won the shot put event at the Navy Outdoor Meet, took the title in the weight throw at the Navy Indoor Meet, and won the shot put event at the Penn Challenge. Sabrina Mortel, swimming and diving. Mortel earned the most points for an Army swimmer at the Patriot League meet, giving her all Patriot League first team honors. Mortel broke two individual program records and was part of an Academy record relay team at the championships. Touching the wall in Army record time, Mortel won the 1650 freestyle. In the 500 freestyle, Mortel placed third with another Academy record time. And the Black Knight Award goes to Sabrina Mortel. This is Sabrina's second nomination, first Black Knight Award win. A native of Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, Sabrina is a member of Company F3. Congratulations on a great sophomore season, Sabrina. We've spent some time tonight looking at individual plays and how much of an impact they have on a game. But how about performances? A player stepping up for a key game or tournament, or simply having the game of his or her career, are just as important. While Associate Athletic Director Gene McIntyre again joins me on stage, let's check out our finalists for Men's Performance of the Year. Kyle Barnes, tennis. Barnes overcame trailing by a point in the third set to win the tiebreaker in a 6-1, 5-7, 7-6, 7-4 victory over his counterpart from Navy at number 5 singles to clinch a 4-3 win for Army and the Patriot League championship. Cody Gary, soccer. Gary scored both Army goals in a 2-1 star win over Navy, finding the net in the 19th minute and the 28th minute. The Black Knights' victory was the program's first in a star match against the midshipmen since 2008. Dean Sakata, golf. Sakata won the individual title at the Patriot League Championships by 9 strokes and became the 10th Army golfer to be selected as the conference's Men's Golfer of the Year. Sakata's score was the lowest in Patriot League Championship history and helped Army win the league title by 22 strokes. And the Black Knight Award goes to Dean Sakata for shooting 11 under at the Patriot League Championships. This is Dean's second nomination, first Black Knight Award win, a native of Diamond Bar, California. He's a member of Company I-2, though he's unable to be here tonight in Albuquerque for the Patriot League Championships coming up this week. Congratulations, Dean, on winning the award. Before we move on, I'd like to welcome to the stage Lindy Clark, a member of last year's women's rugby team that took home Women's Performance of the Year honors. Here are our finalists for this year's Women's Performance of the Year. Sabrina Mortel, swimming and diving. Mortel finished first in the 1650 free at the Patriot League Championships, moving past Boston University and into second place in the meet standings. Mortel overcame Patriot League 25th anniversary team selection Steph Nassen from BU to clinch the top time and set a new academy record. Kelsey Minato, basketball. Minato finished with 32 points to break the Patriot League career scoring record at Boston University, shooting 9 of 16 from the field, including 7 of 13 from three-point range, and making 7 of 8 at the free throw line, while adding 4 assists and 3 steals. Caroline Smith, softball. Smith tossed a no-hitter at Hartford in a 7-0 Army victory, coming just one out shy of a perfect game. The no-hitter was the 7th in Academy history and the 1st since 2011. And the Black Knight Award goes to Caroline Smith for her no-hitter near perfect game in softball's 7-0 win at Hartford earlier this month. This is Caroline's 3rd nomination and her 1st Black Knight Award win. She's a native of Chino Hills, California, and a member of Company G4. Congratulations, Caroline. So we're more than halfway through the 2016 Black Knight Awards. And as many of you know, during the year, we send flip cams. I know they might be outdated here in 2016. With our teams on road trips to give our fans an inside look at what goes on when our Army athletics teams are on the road. We now present to you the best of the flip cams this year.
Hello, Ms. Parker.
Hey.
Shout out, Queens.
Yeah.
I'm the king of Queens.
Yeah.
Shout out to Dirty T.
Dirty T.
Jaden, what is your message to your fans?
Love me, say that you love.
The behind-the-scenes footage will be recorded by yours truly, Too Hot to Handle.
You know, just a little crazy stupid love. We're not soft at all, I swear.
Make you all mine, crazy girl, don't you know that I love you?
Wait a minute. Wasn't I just talking to you?
It's not funny, is it?
Ha! I got the flip cam for media day, coach. You got a fresh cut. That's what's
up.
Yeah,
I did it myself. I put that into it.
Yeah,
Yeah?
Yes.
Does it mean you want to be a senator?
She
has no clue what she's talking about.
I have no idea what I'm talking about, but that's okay. I thought it was inspirational.
Bananas. That's assault, brother.
Kyle McKinney? What time is it?
Game time!
Lindsay Gabo! Headed to branch night. Lindsay, are you excited?
Don't patronize me.
Are you excited? Oh my god.
Here you go.
Here you go. I'm
not home. Gary, right outside?
A little bit.
Figuring some finances out here on the bus. I couldn't tell you what the hell's going on. What's funny is the team thinks I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, here in the wonderful DC area. Taking in the view, taking in the people. ABB. Ha!
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
We get to the Pentagon, we step on the court, we're ready to go, we beat Air Force, we go back to the hotel, we go to sleep, that's it.
Rico, how you doing this morning? What's the temp outside?
I don't know, it's in Celsius, I can't do that math.
Wow.
Go away.
And who are you again?
I'm number 5, Kelsey Minato.
Wait a minute, you're Kelsey Minato?
You're Kelsey Minato?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Truly the best of the flip cams from 2015-2016. Let's keep the awards rolling along with Associate Athletic Director Gaylord Green make his way back to the stage to present the 2016 Black Knight Award for Play of the Year We had so many to choose from. Let's take a look at the remaining nominees. Football, Edgar Poe's touchdown catch against Rutgers. Women's soccer, Katie Holder's overtime game-winning goal against Lafayette. Women's basketball, Aaliyah Murray's steal and layup against Navy. Hockey, Parker Gahagan's diving save against Mercyhurst. Men's basketball, Kevin Ferguson's game-winning tip-in at Navy. Women's lacrosse, Amy Johnston's game-winning goal with 4 seconds left against LIU Brooklyn. And the Black Knight awards go to, we have co-winners, Kevin Ferguson for his tip-in against Navy, and Casey McCravey for her acrobatic run scored yesterday in the Patriot League tournament against Lehigh. This is Kevin's first nomination, first Black Knight Award win, a native of Berkeley Heights, New Jersey. He's a member of Company H3. And for Casey, her fourth nomination, and Casey's first Black Knight Award win, a native of Scottsdale, Arizona. She is a member of Company A2. What a day for Kevin and the Army men's basketball team back in February, and what an individual effort by Casey. You have to be living under a rock if you haven't seen that play over the last 24 hours. Congratulations on a job well done, Casey and Kevin. Next up, I'd like to welcome firstie Jesse Glenn, last year's winner, in our next category to join me on the stage as we present this year's Men's Cow of the Year. And the finalists are Parker Gahagan, hockey. Gahagan led the nation with a .937 save percentage and was an All-Atlantic Hockey second team selection. Gahagan recorded 4 shutouts, with 3 of them coming in the Atlantic Hockey Tournament, as he led the Black Knights to 2 playoff series wins for the first time in program history, and a berth in the Atlantic Hockey semifinals for the first time since 2008. Cole Johnson, lacrosse. Johnson was named to the Towerton Award watch list during the season, led Army in points and assists, and was second on the team in goals. At all Patriot League first team selection, Johnson was second in the league in points per game and had a run of 35 points over 5 games. Chris Linder, baseball. Linder was a first team all Patriot League selection and led Army in batting average, slugging percentage, on base percentage, runs scored, hits, walks, stolen bases, and multi-hit games. Linder's 14 steals were good for second in the conference. And the Black Knight Award goes to Parker Gahagan. This is Parker's third nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Buffalo, New York, he's a member of Company E1. Accepting the award on Parker's behalf is Christian Pomerico. So congrats on a job well done for the team. And of course, Parker Gahagan. We had Coach Riley in the script coming up to accept it, but we could swap some faces on Photoshop a little later. So let's turn our attention to the women's side of things. We welcome Executive Athletic Director Bob Beretta back to the stage to present Women's Cow of the Year. And the finalists are Erin Gelada, lacrosse. Gelada finished the season third on the Black Knights with 17 goals and 24 points. A team co-captain, Gelada had 4 multi-goal games, tallied a season high 4 points on two occasions and scored 2 goals versus American and 1 goal against Navy. Nan Porter, tennis. Porter led Army in wins and finished 21-7 overall and 13-4 in the spring. Porter's 13 dual match and 8 doubles victories ranked second on the team. Overcoming a first set loss to Navy in the fifth singles position, Porter then teamed with freshman Genevieve McCormick for a 6-4 win in the third double spot. Allie Reshenskis, softball. Reshenskis was an All-Patriot League first-team choice, leading Army in triples while standing second on the team in batting average and hits, and third in slugging percentage and on-base percentage. And the Black Knight Award goes to Allie Reshenskis. This is Allie's second nomination, first Black Knight Award win. A native of St. Anne, Illinois, she's a member of Company I-2. Congratulations, Allie. At this time, I'd like to welcome back to the stage Director of Athletics Boo Corrigan to present our three biggest awards of the night. Let's get things started with the three finalists for Men's Firstie of the Year. Philip Choi, Sprint Football. Choi was the Collegiate Sprint Football League co-MVP in helping Army to the CSFL title. An all-CSFL first-team selection, Choi led the league with 15 tackles for loss for 87 yards and 11.5 sacks for 73 yards, and was a member of the winningest senior class in program history, going 28-1 over the last 4 years with 3 CSFL titles. Jesse Glenn, gymnastics. Glenn became the first Black Knight ever to win the Nissen Emory Award as the nation's top male gymnast, was named ECAC Senior Gymnast of the Year, and was an NCAA qualifier in the all-around. The ECAC champion in the all-around, high bar and floor exercise, Glenn also was the USA Gymnastics high bar champion and All-American in all-around, high bar, parallel bars, and vault. Tanner Plum, basketball. Plum led the Patriot League, scoring 19.8 points per game, and was second in the conference with 2.9 three-pointers a game. A first-team All-League choice and All-ECAC second-team selection, Plum scored at least 20 points in 16 of 28 games, including a season-high 31 points in a win over Gardner-Webb. Plum also led all Army players with 24 points at Navy. And the Black Knight Award goes to Jesse Glenn. This is Jesse's third nomination and second Black Knight Award win. He's a native of Porter Ranch, California, and a member of Company C3. Congratulations to Jesse on what's been a great season and a tremendous career here at West Point. Let's move on now and take a look at the three finalists for Women's Firstie of the Year. Casey McRavy, softball. McRavy was named Patriot League Player of the Year after winning the conference batting title, while also topping the league in hits, runs, and steals. McRavy led Army in the majority of offensive statistical categories and was a senior class award finalist. Kelsey Minato, basketball. Minato posted Academy single season records in points, three-pointers, and scoring average, and finished seventh in the country in scoring and second in three-point percentage. an Associated Press All-American Honorable Mention, and WBCA All-America Honorable Mention, Minotta was the Patriot League Player of the Year, First Team All-League Selection, and the Conference Tournament MVP, in leading Army to the NCAA Tournament for the second time in 3 years. Minotta set Army's all-time scoring mark, was the Metropolitan Basketball Writers Association Division I Player of the Year, and ESPNW Mid-Major Player of the Year. Haley Winters, track and field. Winters won the 100 and 200 meter dashes in the outdoor meet against Navy and was part of the winning 4x100 meter relay. She also recorded the third fastest time in school history in the 60 meter dash at the Patriot League Indoor Championships, where she finished third in the 200 meter dash. Winters also was part of the 4x400 meter relay that set the indoor meet record against Navy. And the Black Knight Award goes to Kelsey Minotta. This is Kelsey's eighth nomination and fifth Black Knight Award. A native of Huntington Beach, California, she is a member of Company C4. Congratulations, Kelsey, on a tremendous year, a tremendous career here at West Point. At this time, I'd like to welcome General Caslin to the stage. We've reached the moment you've all been waiting for. Time for our final award of the evening. We're going to take a look at the three finalists for the MacArthur Award, which is presented to our Team of the Year. Sprint football. Army completed its 17th perfect season in program history and won its 34th Collegiate Sprint Football League Championship. The Black Knights scored a program record 86 points in a shutout win over Princeton, one of a school record 5 shutouts on the season. Army defeated Navy in thrilling fashion on October 31st to clinch the CSFL title. Women's basketball. The Black Knights were the Patriot League regular season champions and captured the conference tournament title, as well as a Division I NCAA tournament bid for the third time in their history. Army won a program record 29 games, finished 17-1 in the Patriot League, and posted a conference record 19.5 point per game scoring margin. Golf. The Black Knights captured the Patriot League crown and NCAA bid by winning the conference tournament by 22 strokes. 3 Army golfers finished in the top 5 at the league tournament, while all 6 competitors placed in the top 30. The Black Knights also scored a 6.5 to 4.5 victory over Navy in the fall. And the MacArthur Award goes to women's basketball. Would head coach Dave McGarrity and the team please make their way to the stage to accept the award. Congratulations to the women's basketball team on a tremendous season. We look forward to cheering you all on again next season. Thank you, Boo. Thank you, General Caslin. So while we don't have any more hardware to give out, the celebration is not completely over. Before we depart tonight, join me as we take a look back at some of the best moments of what has been a memorable year. Relax and enjoy this tremendous highlight film and all the films tonight put together by our own Zach Daly, who's done a tremendous job with them. And let's roll our year-end highlights. What a way to end such a wonderful night. Before we bid farewell, I have one final request. If you're holding a Black Knight Award in your hands right now, don't leave just yet. We'd like to have you come back on the stage for a quick group photo before you depart. And for everyone else, be sure to stay in your seats for a montage of tonight's top photos on the video screen. Ladies and gentlemen, that will do it for this year's Black Knight Awards. Thank you to everyone who had a hand in making this such a huge success. Also, congratulations and best of luck to all members of the West Point Class of 2016 as graduation week commences. For those of you returning, we'll see you back here again in 2017. Have a great night, everyone. I have to celebrate you, baby.